Hi, I'm Joan Lima, editor of The Economy, and here with me I've got Gisle Eckhoff, CEO of DigiPlex. Gisle, thanks a lot for talking to me again. We spoke a few months ago. Can you tell me more about the Nordics data center market and how that's evolved over the last 9 months?
Right. It has been a very, very interesting period since we met 7-8 months ago, and especially taking into consideration that some of the hyperscale companies like Amazon decided to come to Sweden. And also the announcement of Facebook starting up in Denmark. So it is an extremely high activity in the Nordic region. And there is a number of good reasons for it. And in fact, since we met, there has also been some significant changes in the tax system for power in Norway and Sweden, where basically they have cut the tax by 95% by 1st of January this year. Which of course is extremely attractive both to our customers but also to the hyperscale companies.
A very interesting thing about the Nordics is that the government seems to actually have understood what data centers are and how critical they are to the new economy.
Yes.
What was the role of the industry to make sure the government understood what's behind the new economy?
Right. So so what we're doing is that we are working very closely with the various governments in the region, both to make sure that there's a consistent message. But when you look into an overall global picture, you will see that the sustainability is high on the agenda. And when you look at the renewable energy that we are providing to all our data centers, which is 100% renewable, it is extremely focused because it is a significant part of all power consumed globally is going to the data center industry. So it will have a major impact to reduce that. So it is a huge alignment between the governments to promote this. So also us as colo players are working actively in the market in Europe to get the message out that they should come to the region and we should then support them in their business also to drive down the pollution and make sure that we have the green agenda in place.
And also bring costs down.
Yes.
And then on the critical infrastructure, then we go into the Nordic region as a whole.
Yeah.
Do the Nordics recognize data centers has critical infrastructure, such as, for example, an airport or an oil refinery? How is the debate going on in the Nordics? Because in Europe, it's not recognized. So the UK has some legislation that do say data centers are critical infrastructure, but some other countries are still very warmly. But the Nordics seems to be a bit further ahead on that.
Yeah, but when I look at the evolution of, for instance, like mobile phones, Sweden was the first country in the world that had 3G. It was the first at 4G. So the whole region are used and they're very, very, let's say, mature in digitalization. So we, as people living in the region, we used to be in the digital world. And as a consequence of that, we are very focused on all everything with security because it is such an important part of our day-to-day life. So it is very high on the agenda. And you're right when you're saying that. That and another thing which is also quite important when you talk about broader context is that a number of places in Europe are running out of power. In the region, Nordic region, there are unlimited power. Cheap, sustainable power. And this is very, very important also from a security point of view that there is that the grids are of course extremely well and advanced and stable, but also the power, unlimited power, which is an issue in parts of Europe today.
Oh yeah, especially Dublin is running out of energy,
yes,
for example.
Yes, yes.
And then when you look at the Nordics region as well, so the governments have understood what data centers are. They are investing in data centers. They allow companies to invest in data centers. But the whole region seems to be coming together to create a massive data center hub.
Yes.
So some people are saying it will actually be the capital, so the Nordics will be the capital of data centers in Europe, and then you just have regional data centers across Europe to respect data sovereignty laws and all those sort of things. What's coming next? What are you planning in terms of the Nordic region?
No, so what we are doing is that some of us are kind of coordinating this and very closely working with the Business Sweden, Invest in Norway, Invest in Denmark, Invest in Finland, which are run by the government. And by having all of these forces in one direction, it gives a lot of, let's say, traction from the global players, but also, of course, the rest of the world. The thing I'm sure is that it will be more and more focused on the CSR agendas of companies. And we can see that it picks up, and more now it is in the boardrooms, and it's a key differentiator in the marketplace if you are having a green data center or not. So we can see a huge pickup in interest around that. So coming back to your question, that will be a lot of the changes coming forward. Will we see a lot of requests based on that?
Okay. So what's the debate the CEOs are having when you talk to them, especially your CEO customers?
Now, of course, the cost is always. And some of the challenges I see is that some companies, if you look in Europe, they look at what is the rent. And to me, that's the wrong question. The question is, what is the total cost of ownership?
Which means, do you get out of it?
Yes, and that includes power, includes, of course, rent, fiber, and everything. And when you look into the TCO context, you will see that this region is very, very competitive, even when you look into the broader European customer base. So this TCO is a key element of each company's decision, not just what is the rent per kilowatt.
And then DigiPlex is one of the largest data center players in the Nordics and the largest in Norway. What have you been doing over the last few months that's going to help you build the future? What's the roadmap for the next few months?
Right. So we have been around 10, 15 years in Norway, and we are the number one there.
You're established now.
Yes. So we are the dominant player. But then we decided some years ago to penetrate Sweden. And we have built the largest commercial data center in Sweden. And at the moment, the good news is that we are getting a lot of new customers on board.
And so how much space has been used in that new data center in Sweden, for example? What's the percentage of users in the data center in Sweden?
No, I don't want to disclose the number of users, but we're having a lot of customers signed over the last few months, which we're now building out for, and a lot of interest. And the rationality is that we're using total new technology, air-to-air. We have a very, very low PUE, 1.1, 1.2, high security. Everything is top-notch, which means that some of these legacy data centers that are around is firstly it's very costly to drive, but it's also very unfriendly to the environment. So a lot of this is now looking into to make a move. And we did a survey last year on what are the buying behavior on the CXOs with respect to in-house versus outsourced data center. And today in Sweden, for instance, 55% of all companies have their own in-house data centers. But they also said that within 24 months, that number will reduce from 55 to 35. So there's a major shift now to move from legacy old data centers into a new facilities. So that's why we also see the enormous pickup in customers.
Does that mean we're going to see DigiPlex expanding its footprint?
Yes. So at the moment, we want to take also a dominant position in Sweden, and now we are looking into to Denmark and Finland. A little bit more opportunistic, but we can see that with some of the very large global players landing in Denmark, we will be there to support them, both with their partners. But I think the main thing is that we see the global players as a very, very important part of the ecosystem. And our philosophy is to be the edge provider in Stockholm, Oslo, Copenhagen, Helsinki. That is our philosophy, is to support them in deployment near where people are living. So that's the whole strategy at the moment. So it'll be a complementary value proposition to the large global players.
So it's quite an ambitious strategy. But are we going to see DigiPlex coming out of the Nordics and set up data centers elsewhere in Europe?
And
is that too early?
That's not the agenda at the moment.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
And the reason is the climate, Nordic. We have the power, we have the renewable energy. So everything is where we believe we should be.
Okay. So and whatever you do, you have to respect the same standards of the Nordic.
That's what we, so that's clear. And also that's where we differentiate ourselves from a lot of others. So for us, it is key that we have these key elements that is our differentiator.
What also differentiates you from the others, and which is also quite interesting, is the fact that you own your facility, so you own the asset. That makes you very valuable for acquisitions. Are there any conversations with other players? Have you been approached to be acquired? Would you be considering it?
Yeah, so what's happening in the industry, as you know, it is a huge consolidation at the moment. Every day there's some new. So of course there are interest, but we have not any thought about that because we have been now around for the last 15, 16 years. And our owners have no ambition of doing any of that at the moment because there is such a a need also to have an independent player like us. And I think what you see is that with all the awards that we're winning on the conferences like the 2 days ago, one thing is that the innovation that we can provide, because we are flexible and we are owned by people who would like to invest and bring the company forward, is a key element in this. So that's why we're winning all these awards, which is for us also a confirmation that we're doing the right things. So it's a not only for innovation of new technology, but the one that we won 2 days ago was basically to refurbish an old data center into a new and modern platform. To bring our customer up to speed. So this is this is key for us to work on these elements, and of course backed by the owners who are willing to invest in making sure that it's a sustainable business.
Yeah, then it comes down to this, the market demand that we're seeing around scalability.
Yes. So so all our sites, they are scalable in the sense that we can grow on existing sites. We have, for instance, in Stockholm 30,000 square meter of land where we can basically build new data centers. So this, the flexibility is important to our customers.
Okay, Gisle, thanks for talking to me. Don't forget, you can follow Data Economy on Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn, and also visit the website on www.data-economy.com.